Every seat of SolidWorks comes with a large customizable material library. Material library contains a definition of each material, including its mechanical properties, things like mass, tensile and compressive strength, and thermal conductivity values. When a material is applied to a component, allows for accurate calculation of mass, moments, and center of gravity. This information can also be used with SolidWorks simulation tools to calculate how parts and assemblies will perform under different types of loading condition. To apply material to a component, either right-click in the Feature Manager tree and select Edit Material, or use the Custom Property tab to do the same. The library is organized into material categories and is also fully searchable, making it easy to find the material you need. The material library is easily customizable, allowing you to create your own materials either from scratch or by copying and editing existing material definitions. You can create a custom material library by simply right-clicking in the material library tree and selecting New Library. If you're part of a team of SolidWorks users, it is highly recommended to place this new library in a shared location so that all users can make use of it. You will need to point SolidWorks to this location, which we'll cover later. Materials can be defined from scratch, but the easiest way to create new material is to find something similar and copy it. You can also add your own material categories, such as steel, plastic, and timber, and simply paste the copy of material into the correct folder. All materials in the custom library are fully editable, so you can change everything from the material name to make it easily recognizable, its visual appearance, and also its mechanical properties. Material data can be obtained in a number of ways, including material data sheets from the supplier or by visiting matweb.com and searching through the online database of material definition. If you use certain materials frequently, it might be a good idea to customize your material favorites list. This can be done by clicking on Manage Favorites, finding a material and clicking on the Add button to add it to the list. This list can be reordered using the up and down buttons. Finally, you'll need to add the location of your new material library to SolidWorks so it can find it. The folder path is set in the SolidWorks System Options under File Locations for Material Databases.